A little girl is wheeled from the operating theatre, not to a recovery room, but a doorway in the corridor. There's nowhere else available. The world's most famous children's hospital is running out of space and facilities. Countless young lives have been saved and made better here. 70,000 outpatients and 9,000 inpatients were treated last year. Parents are encouraged to stay with their children, often meaning camp beds in already tiny rooms, or parents sleeping in waiting rooms.
So we're trying to carry out all the nursing care that's required, particularly with children who are critically ill, requiring a lot of apparatus in a very small environment. Perhaps what gets us down is that we're offering such a poor facility when the children coming here deserve the very best, and their parents also deserve a good environment to be helping us care for their children.
The money will be spent on new buildings, operating theatres, intensive care and many other facilities, providing space for patients and staff to cope better. Now, for example, the playrooms also use as a classroom and parents' sitting room.
One of the problems is that we've got all different age groups of children, so very often you're setting up different activities for different age groups, so therefore having a big room and plenty of space to move would enable you to do that more effectively, and so the children will get much more out of it.
There are only 5 lifts to cater for 330 inpatients and 700 nursing staff. That's not counting other medical and ancillary staff, outpatients, parents and visitors. One thing never squeezed out, though, is the welcome the children get.
I like it here, though.
What's so special about it, though?
So friendly. Everybody's friendly to you.
And they make you feel better that way, do they?
Yeah.
Great. Oh, well, we hope it works this time. You don't have to come back again.
Thank you.
Standing proudly in the shadow of the elderly buildings that are due to be demolished is the wishing well, where the public are asked to leave their donations towards the new hospital, due to open in 1993. Tricia Ingrams, Thames News.